Hey man, what's up? Oh my god, you brought me a cupcake! Oh. Oh hi! I didn't hear you come in! You're probably wondering what's the deal with this cupcake from earlier. Well, you see, today's the- this chair doesn't swivel. Hello everyone, I'm Nate Bittatiner, but you knew that already, and I'm bringing you a semi-candid video talking about the 1 year anniversary of my very first upload on this channel. Woo! That was actually a lot more than I thought it was gonna be.
It landed on the tripod.
At the date of this video going up, it has been officially a year since I made my very first video and debuted it here on the channel, which was the Why I Love My Hero Academia video, which was sort of just kind of like a test to see how my video editing skills have been since I haven't made a video prior to that for like 3 years. But it really is such a surreal experience that it's already been a year. It doesn't feel like it. It feels like I just got Adobe Premiere not that long ago, and I... apparently, time just flies by when you're having fun. In order to celebrate such a huge milestone to me, I've decided to cap off the year with a Q&A special that I had some of my friends come up with some questions, along with a few that I came up with in order for you guys to get a better understanding of me and how the process works here on the channel. This will also be serving as the season one finale of my channel, because I like to think of every year that passes by from now on as kind of like a season of a TV show with the amount of work that goes into each review and why I love video. I originally intended for this video to air alongside another review that I was gonna work on for this month, but due to some timing issues and weather conditions, one of the conventions that I was gonna be going to earlier this year got moved to this month, which coincidentally was about a week and a half away from another convention I was going to, so I realistically didn't want to try and do two videos and two conventions all at the same time, because I didn't want to half-ass either. And I'm sure by the time this video actually comes out, I'm gonna be dead exhausted editing it. So I figure just a little bit of an extra long Q&A in order to cap off the season. But with that, let's kick off these questions, shall we? I'm not good at segueing. Question one. The idea of a Minecraft Battle Royale system... Wrong book.
What is your favorite anime?
My favorite anime, if you couldn't tell from this tattoo alone, is Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. And the reason for that is, have you watched it? It is an emotional roller coaster of just amazingness. Like, I know that that is a terrible way to describe it as someone who's trying to be a reviewer, but it is just, it has such a great story about two brothers trying to atone for their past mistakes. The animation is f***ing solid, just all the way around. The music, oh my god, the music. But for exact reasons, I could probably go the entire video just me talking about this anime alone, but I would like to really save that for a future video I would like to do on it. So I'm afraid I can't go into too much more details about it. Sorry.
How do you go about picking a series to review or discuss?
Oh, that's an easy question. I just review whatever the hell I feel like watching at the time. Sometimes it might be one of the newer animes that just started airing, or sometimes it could be one of the older series that I already own and have already watched before but feel like talking about again with you guys. I know some YouTubers really only want to focus on the newer shows that come out, which I completely understand, but I also want my channel to be mainly be about the stuff that I want to talk about, which will include some of the new stuff as it airs, but sometimes I might not get to a newer show until way after it airs.
Do you own any hentai?
Really, guys? You think with this kind of anime collection I'd be the kind of guy to own any
About how long are your scripts and how long does it take to write them?
Honestly, it really just depends on the video I'm working on. Like, some of my scripts can be shorter depending on if it's a topic that I feel doesn't need as much of an info dump as, say, like, a big series that I'm reviewing, just like how I recently did Darling in the Franxx, which turned out to be a 25-minute video. I did not intend for that, but it just, I had so much that I wanted to talk about, which is why it ended up being as long as it did. And usually, I usually try to dedicate almost a whole week trying to compile my thoughts on a series after I watch it in the script format. And that usually works out pretty well for me. If you haven't noticed, some of my older videos used to be around like the 5 to 7 minute mark, which was fine at the time, but I felt like I wasn't making the super quality kind of content that I wanted, and that's why I switched to now more of a one video per month schedule. That way I can get all my thoughts out on paper and have enough time to compile or edit them together in order to make a quality video for you guys.
Do you have any pets?
Well, yes, if you've seen my Gretzko video, you've seen my tabby cat Cassie, who actually used to be my roommate's cat, but because we've come to realize that she loves me the most in this household, and they're eventually going to be moving out soon and want to get more of a, like a bird or another pet of their own, they decided to just leave her with me, and which is pretty great because I love that cat and she loves me. In fact, she loves me so much that she's been chilling in my room, just hanging out with me this whole time. Isn't that right?
What is your favorite video that you've made so far?
Favorite video that I've made currently, I'd have to say, is the Yandere video. The reason for that is because it was my really first big departure from just doing reviews on my channel. I know I came out with a Why I Love technically to start the channel, but that was really just a short test to see how my editing skills were. The Yandere video was such a big editing challenge that I really enjoyed tackling because for my previous videos where I just reviewed like a single anime, I only had to take clips from that one specific source. But for the Yandere video, because it's a topic that spread across so many different anime series, manga, games, etc., that I was able to use a bunch of different resources, really think outside the box and think creatively. Like my Bowser theory, I was so excited when I thought of that, just the spur of the moment. In fact, that was one of the big reasons why I wanted to make the video. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, maybe you should go watch it.
Are you a good singer?
Am I? No!
What is your all-time favorite Pokemon?
That is a difficult question because I love a lot of Pokemon. I don't know why I'm pretending to think so hard. It's my boy Blaziken! Some of the reasons why he's my number one favorite Pokemon, even though I have a lot of favorites that I absolutely adore. He's a badass, fire-using, fighting chicken, which is kind of funny to say out loud. But I just really love Blaziken's design and the whole concept behind him. In fact, going to a childhood story of mine, me and my brother grew up really heavily with the third generation of Pokemon. I had Pokemon Sapphire, he had Pokemon Ruby, and my starter was Mudkip and his starter was Torchic. And if you didn't know, Mudkip goes into Swampert and Torchic goes into Blaziken in their third evolution. Now, the Mudkip line to Swampert will always be some of my favorite Pokemon, but as a kid, whenever I used to battle my brother and he'd always use his Blaziken, he would wipe the floor with my team using moves like Sky Uppercut and Fire Punch. And, you know, it wasn't really that hard to beat me because I was a kid and I really didn't know much. Didn't know better when it came to using type advantages or really just RPG mechanics in general. But because my brother always used Blaziken, I always got to see its moves in action, I just became really fascinated with the Pokemon. So when Pokemon Emerald eventually came out, I decided to use Torchic as my starter. And when it evolved into Blaziken, I dominated the Hoenn region, and he just has been my favorite ever since.
How did you learn to edit your videos?
Well, actually, I took 3 years of video classes in high school in order to learn the basics of video editing and just shooting skits in general. But for all the stuff that I've been doing in Adobe Premiere, which is the editing software I use now, I've been mainly self-taught through video tutorials on YouTube and a bunch of Adobe articles.
What is your dick size?
Aw, come on, guys. It's just your average 40. See? Just a standard, 40 card Yu-Gi-Oh deck, nothing special. I like to use Elemental Hero. Sorry, this was just a fun little bit that I came up with to get Yu-Gi-Oh in the video, because I f***ing love Yu-Gi-Oh.
Who are some of your inspirations / favorite YouTubers?
Oh gosh, I have so many inspirations and favorite YouTubers out there that this is kind of a hard question to only just name a few. I guess some anime specific YouTubers, I would have to say Giguk, Mother's Basement, Akidiris, Joey the Anime Man. They have built so many wonderful communities of people just to talk about anime and just enjoy the media as a whole, and I really inspire to do the same with building my own little community and having just be able to talk to people about things I'm passionate about, especially anime. Other YouTubers also inspired me to do that as well, like the Game Grumps, Jacksepticeye, Pro Jared. So many YouTubers that I could probably make a giant list of people that inspire me for how wonderful they are and just how they can bring communities together and just be great people.
Do you have any plans to add gaming to the channel?
Yes, and matter of fact, I would really love to add gaming to the channel. Not necessarily Let's Plays. If I were to do something like that, I would make an entirely separate channel for that, but I would love to add game reviews to the channel. Unfortunately, I only have OBS currently. I don't have any capture cards or any real knowledge of how I'd go about recording console games, but there are so many RPGs like Persona, Kingdom Hearts, and a whole bunch of other games I'd love to bring to the channel. And on that note, honestly, I'd love to at some point be able to talk about other nerdy related things. Like, I want to always have anime and manga be like the main kind of content on the channel, but I would love to throw in a random comic series, cartoon series here and there in order just to bring some variety into this channel. After all, I am the 8-bit Tata nerd, and I have a lot of nerdy interests that I think would be fun to talk about with you guys. But no matter what, anime will always be the mainstay on this channel. But for right now, those are all just future plans for maybe way down the line, maybe on like a season 3 or season 4 kind of topic. Yes, that's right, I do plan on making YouTube videos for quite a while.
How many tattoos do you have?
At the time of this video, I have 9 tattoos. I have the Deathly Hallows on my wrist, the homunculus symbol along with all the deadly sins on my shoulder, my Kingdom Hearts chest piece, my Monokuma Danganronpa tattoo on this shoulder, my Rainbow Dragon Yu-Gi-Oh tattoo, my Legend of Zelda Wind Waker Toon Link. I also have a Black Frost from Persona 3 and 5, well, all the Persona games, on my leg, along with Lilo and Stitch Big Hero 6 Christmas themed tattoo on the other, and I also have a behind the ear tattoo of a Haunter. I think I listed all of my tattoos. I do plan on getting a lot more nerdy tattoos very soon.
What made you interested in video making / wanting to start your own YouTube account?
I saved this question for last because I think this would be a good note to end on. So what interested me in video making in general was YouTube itself. Like, I originally discovered the platform way back when it was like the star format instead of the like and dislike system. I was just a young kid trying to find Yu-Gi-Oh! GX episodes that weren't in English yet. That's an old-fashioned statement if I've ever heard one. But I also discovered other YouTubers just uploading like short clips of themselves talking or making manga collection videos that inspired me. Like, hey, I had a manga collection. I could make a video about that, and then I just kept making little webcam clips of me showing off a new manga book that I would get, which was really just nothing special. Eventually, that channel was very long gone at this point when I used to make content back then. But that passion for making videos always stuck with me, which inspired me to do 3 years of film in high school. And then afterwards, when I was able to get a job and able to afford just basic equipment, I started messing around, and here I am now. The concept of video making being an outlet in order to create your own stories through your own vision, whether it be just showing off something you like, or telling a funny story, or hey, making a movie, has always been fascinating to me, and I've always just wanted to talk about the things I love and just see if people will listen. And honestly, here we are now. As I mentioned earlier, the idea of really creating your own community of people in order to talk about things that you enjoy and just having a safe space for people in order to talk freely has always been one of my biggest goals and is one of the biggest things I want to come out of this channel. I want people to talk about their nerdy interests to me, able to hear what I have to say, and just, you know, build a dialogue and just have fun. And honestly, that is what YouTube is to me right now, is just having fun. If I could ever make it into some sort of career like I know 1,000 of other people have done, that would be amazing. But for right now, it is just a fun hobby for me. And I love being able to talk to people whenever they comment on my channel about an anime that I reviewed and they've also enjoyed, or if they have a different opinion. That's completely fine. As long as you're respectful and, you know, will listen to the other person and, you know, just have a fun dialogue about it. But, that's pretty much the very roundabout way of answering what made me want to get into YouTube. And with that, those are all the questions I had for you guys today. I hope you were able to get some insight on me and also how the video making process works on this channel. Before I wrap things up, I want to give a big thank you to all my friends that have starred in that little intro skits in my videos. I could not have made them without you guys. It was a lot of fun filming with you all, and I can't thank you guys enough. And a thank you to my family and friends that encourage my hobby and share my content around. It really means a lot to me. And lastly, just a big thank you to you guys, the viewer, for even just watching my stuff to begin with. It is just an amazing feeling that someone would even want to actually listen to my rambles and thoughts about an anime that they might be interested in as well. It's just amazing to me. Now, in a proper season one finale fashion, I am going to be taking the month of May off from video making. Reason being is because I want to have time to prep for season two in order to make sure that a lot of the cool video ideas that I have really come out the best that they can be. And also be able to plan out more reviews, why I love videos, because those are some big editing challenges. And also some other ideas that I have, like maybe even a couple more candid videos like this one, if this really is received well enough. But also at the same time, able to take some time off in order to catch up on some shows that I've been meaning to, and, you know, just hang out with friends. You don't want that YouTube burnout to happen, which is weird to say, seeing how I make a video only once a month, but I also do have a full-time job and social obligations that I have to go to. Look at me saying it like social obligations, like I'm that much of an important person. I am. But I think it'd be really beneficial to take this time off, not only for me, but also for the future content on this channel. But if you still want to keep up to date on me or just how progress on videos are going, you can follow me at the 8bit10nerd Twitter account, where I'll be posting like mini updates on just how the video process is going, like, and maybe just, you know, fun tidbits on how I'm doing.
Also be updating when I get a new chair!
But if you are curious on what I have planned for season 2, you might want to stick around to the end of the video just for a little bit of a sneak peek of what I have in store for you guys. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you really enjoyed this more candid approach for video making, you can let me know by hitting that thumbs up button. Yes, I still gotta do it, even in live action. And if you are new to the channel and are interested in some possible nerdy-related content I will come out in the future, hitting that subscribe button will be the best way to make sure you don't miss out on my season 2 premiere and just any other future things I may talk about. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some really great things planned for this channel that I just gotta prep for.